Well, the wolves have been busy, but the blood is long dry. So it is you, Tatien.
If that's true, then the body next to hers will be Yannick's. The girl Yannick went off to see every night. You said her name was Tatien.
You. Did you follow me?
Now, why would I do that? Unless you think I'd have good reason to. But no. I was sent to find Yannick. And by the looks of things, I have.
We both found who we were searching for.
Nah, he was a jealous sod. Couldn't stand the thought of his woman with someone else. Then one day he sees her with a new comb. Thinks she's got herself a new gallant. Tells the garrison he's going to find the man and kill him. We know it's all talk, but then he disappears off to Moor for some dealings and doesn't come back.
If you mean this comb, it was a gift from the dame.
If only Yannick had bothered to ask, eh? He might not be rotting on a hill.
I think he meant to ask her something else. He stole the old comb and bought her a new one. In the hope they'd wed.
Wed? Where would they have gone? Certainly not back to Northreach with a dame waiting. And we all know what happens to deserters. Tell the dame I'm sorry for her loss. When the lads come to collect Yannick's body, I'll see that Tatien is delivered to the Vale.
Is that wise?
Ah, there won't be any covering up this mess. The most we can hope for is that the dame doesn't hold it against us. Speaking of which, I saw her in Moor just now. Could you tell her what happened? Might sound better coming from you.
I need to tell Isabel. Perhaps the comb will give her something to remember Tatien by.
You are still in one piece, I see. You will be pleased to hear that your companions have arrived. They said they would meet you at a little chapel to the east of here.
Thank you, but you needn't have come all this way just to tell me. I was on my way to see you.
You found her then? My dear Tatien, it is by no means uncommon for a client to fall for a courtesan. Especially a client who is young and far from home. But rarely do such tales have happy endings.
I found this with Tatien. I believe it was yours.
Thank you for returning it. I shall see that it has a place on her pyre.
I should go.
Before you do, I have one last gift. A token of my thanks. The Vale counts among its patrons several high-ranking officers of the Imperial Army. According to one of the looser-tongued gentlemen, it would appear that the legions are planning to march south.
Or to mention the same thing.
But did he mention that it was all of the legions? This is no mere skirmish. Were I to guess, I'd say the Emperor planned to abandon the capital. But that couldn't possibly be true now, could it? Take care, Clive.
I will. And thank you again.
Weren't expecting any new branded until the new moon.
Any trouble on the way?
None worth mentioning.
As I was telling Jill, it's worse than I thought. The capital's crawling with soldiers.
And here I am, the deserter come home.
Which is why we'll be taking the back door. Cheer up, you two. Can't think of a safer place in the Empire than it. Brothel.
Really? Doesn't seem very private.
So then, how do we proceed?
We'll be using the glass gate. Tonight, just after sunset.
Where the shards are loaded for transport. That is one of the most heavily guarded points in all of Sambrek.
But not the most, which is a start. Besides, I know a shortcut straight to the heart.
A shortcut? And how exactly did you come to know about this fatal chink in the Empire's armor?
Let's just say I may have attempted something similar before. And may have ended up running for dear life after being discovered by Bahamut, but that's not important.
Cid, if the Mother Crystals truly are the cause of the Blight...
If? You wound me, Jill.
What I'm trying to say is, if the powers that be know all of this, why do they sit idle and allow it to continue?
In case you haven't noticed, the God-fearing people of this realm and their pious leaders care for but one thing, themselves. And they'll do whatever it takes to hold on to power. The rest of us are just a means to an end. The moment you raise your voice against them, you're decried as an outlaw, clapped in irons and slung in a cell to rot.
An outlaw.
Whoever controls the crystals controls the realm. But our kind can wield magic without them. To our rulers, we must seem the most convenient of tools, and the most dangerous.
But what makes them think they have the right to use us? To leave us to die when our bodies are spent?
Does a nobleman weep for a broken mug? A torn tunic? Our fate means nothing to them. No, this isn't a battle you can win with words. Believe me, I've tried, but nothing ever gets through. The world is simply not ready to listen. So to hell with talking. If they won't give us a say, we'll decide our fates another way. You can't blame a man for wanting to bring an end to all this, can you?
I can't. But what of all the people you mean to rob of their comforts? Are you happy for them to call you outlaw?
Cid the Outlaw. Aye, that'll do me.
You might at least pretend to take this seriously.
Have a little faith, Jill. Even if you don't think much of my choice of digs. If it means my deeds will be remembered, I'll gladly play the role of villain. But first, we have a gate to crash. And once we're in, there'll be no turning back. So you best make ready. The world won't save itself.
There are not nearly enough men here.
Then it's fortunate the city guard doesn't take sentry assignment as seriously as you do. This bodes well.
That'll be a first. This may not be such a terrible plan after all.
And what exactly is that supposed to mean?
Only that your last secret shortcut was nowhere near as secret as you claimed.
Yeah, but that's half the fun of it. Life's too short for perfect plans. You want a plan that'll keep you on your toes, stop you growing old and complacent.
Worked for you, has it?
Clive, my boy, even life's smallest challenges offer the opportunity to grow and to change. You must embrace these moments. Allow them to suffuse your heart with a deep sense of fulfillment.
Narrowly escaping death at the hands of an enemy is not my idea of fulfillment.
Something wrong?
Not at all. Just wondering if the two of you had finished.
Right. We make for the Mother Crystal's heart as planned. Destroy it and the whole thing should come tumbling down.
And if the passage to the Inner Sanctum is guarded?
Then we embrace the moment and use it to grow and change. Come on, this way. Try to stay out of sight.
Obviously.
Don't worry, the passage is empty. It never stood a chance.
You're welcome.
The main tunnel.
That would be my guess. There are sentries everywhere.
Things must come to an end. We might have a bit more company from now on.
Captain!
To arms, men! And summon the cannoneer! At once!
Ah!
the moment I was talking about earlier.
What have we here? More insects come to be squashed? You will find my mortar and I only too happy to oblige.
You're a talker.
Then let's shut him up.
Used to that. Akashic or no, he was still a man. A man who drowned in ether.
It's no way for anyone to go.
Come on.
Guard duty's a death sentence in this place. Not that Sylvester cares. Deep of the blessing, my friends. You've said being a dominant doesn't have its benefits.
Sid, this is an ether flood.
There shouldn't be one here, should there? The workers couldn't survive this.
Well, it wasn't here last time, I can tell you that. Which means we need to be quick. The ether won't hurt us, but I'd rather not find out what it's done to everyone else.
In.
Doesn't look that far. Right. Why, yo! Whoa! Some help.
Hold on!
I used to be.
I'll take that as a thank you.
Look on the bright side, eh? At least you won't get lost.
Thank you.
See, they replaced that wooden door with something a little more sturdy. On the count of three.
Three.
happened to two?
Ask one.
Once more.
Aye, seeing as you're trying now. As if that was going to keep us out. The Mother Crystal's just up ahead.
Is it? I can't see a thing.
Well, unless someone's moved it. There's no one about.
I knew it would be big. But this...
There. That's our way into the inner sanctum. You'd think they'd have patched that up by now. Sorry state the Empire's in.
Wait. You don't mean...
Aye. My little game of hide-and-seek with Bahamut ended here. A tragic cost to this remarkable architecture. Don't blame me, he started it.
But how did he make it out alive?
Walked. You should try it.
Oh, no.
Let me go.
Is there something you two want to tell me?
Maybe later.
But how could those creatures from Phoenix Gate be here in the mines?
Are the two places connected somehow?
awake!
In the Imperial Army, soldiers assigned to the Glass Gate would tell stories about something they called the Guardian.
Can't say I saw anything like that when I was last here. Then again, I can't say I made it this far.
Let's just be careful then. Where did that come from?
If I had to guess... Poor beast. Another victim of the Flood.
He wants.
Ready, Clive?
Always.
Too slow.
Yeah.
Are you all right?
Fine.
The inner sanctum lies just beyond. Chances are the palace guard knows we're here. We should move. Not that any sane commander would send his men into a place awash with this much ether. Clive. Hmm? If this all works and the blessing fades, things are likely to get worse for our kind before they get better. Being the last to wield ether will make our talents that much more sought after, by which I mean hunted. I just hope, in the end, they'll see that we didn't have any other choice, that it was the only way to get us to a better place.
And here I was thinking I was the uncertain one. Luckily, two out of three of us have faith in you.
Then it all starts here. Time to earn that menacing title. Sid the Vicious, was it? Second thoughts?
Not me.
We're with you to the end, Sid.
Then what are we waiting for?
Beautiful.
The heart of Sambrek.
Well, that didn't work. I think we're gonna need a bigger sword.
Mine's bigger.
Thank you, Clive, but I meant that figuratively. The core's clearly made of sterner stuff. Taja's going to have a fit when she hears about this. Stand back. It's about to get cramped in here.
Look.